first of all, congratulations that AK versus AK has been a great hit. And so how was your experience with it? With the precise
hit? Thank you.
Yes.
Yeah, sorry, go ahead.
Yes, so the role, you had a very precise but a significant role in the film. So how was your experience with it?
Well, first of all, thank you for, you know, the lovely wishes. And it's a very interesting experience overall. There were so many facets to my experience. You know, number one, it was my second time working with Vikram. And I hadn't been on a set for a very long time because I shot Bhavesh in 2017. And the film released in 2018. And then we ended up shooting AK vs. AK in 2020. So I'd had a long gap, you know, and it was interesting to, after such a long time, you know, Vikram and I both ended up meeting again on that same set, and we ended up working together again. The second facet of it was obviously working with my dad. Then the third facet for the first time, the third facet, third unique thing about it was we were kind of all playing fictionalized versions of ourselves. You know, so there was kind of a lot to digest. And you know, the role was obviously, it's not a long role, but the scenes that Vikram had written for me were very challenging scenes, especially that 1 3-4 minute long monologue, that crazy scene, you know, and the dining table scene as well. So when I got the script, I read it and I kind of realized that one scene was like one of the longer scenes in the film, you know. And it wasn't like a conversational scene. It was more just like a performance, like this character's putting in a performance. And we're not used to that in our normal lives, right? Normally we have conversations. So you say something, I listen, I try and listen as well as possible, I respond. And, you know, that's how we naturally exist, you know? So I wasn't really, I was very anxious about it. And so I took the material and I actually worked on it for about a month. Because I just really wanted to make sure that those 10 minutes that I'm in the film, I really wanted to kind of color that character, and I wanted people to kind of that for that character to break the tension and really make people laugh, you know, and just be crazy and be hysterical. And so I worked on it for a long time, and eventually went and did the scene, and you know, it was a one long take. That monologue was like that one long take. There were no cuts, you know, so it was just me putting in a performance, and I really enjoyed it. I was very nervous, but it, you know, turned out really, like, really well. And I'm very happy, I'm very ecstatic with it, to be honest.
And it actually set the pace, you know, of the film, that there was a tension, and you being you, so it set the pace of the film. So so now tell us about, what are you shooting right now? Where are you exactly? I know you're not in Bombay, so.
Well, I'm contractually bound, so I can't tell you too much about the film, but it's a Netflix original, and it's a thriller drama, and it's actually quite a big film. It's you know, it's one of the bigger films, and yeah, it'll be out, I think, towards the end of the year, and I'm done shooting it on the 22nd of Feb.
Okay.
And I've been here since the 28th of December.
It's a quite long schedule. So
it is a beginning.
Yes. So and when we can expect Abhinav Bindra's release? We have been waiting for it for quite some long time.
Well, Abhinav Bindra will probably shoot this winter in Chandigarh. So you'd probably expect to see it in cinemas in 2022. Hopefully by then, obviously, the vaccine is widespread and cinemas, you know, I mean, I think I've already heard that 100% capacity is now been greenlit. So hopefully by then, you know, the viewers are kind of going back, and that's my next big screen release. And the reason that it's taken so long is because we've honestly just been working on the script. You know, Sai Win, who wrote Neerja, has been working on the script. And we have a new director called Hiraz Marfatia, who was nominated. His short film called Birju was nominated for an Oscar many years ago. And he's worked with Shekhar Kapoor for many years. And he's a very intelligent guy. So him and Sai Win have been working on the script. And we're very ambitious about the Bindra biopic. And we didn't want to rush into making it just for the sake of making it. We wanted to make sure that everybody is really happy with the story. And whenever you're making a film about somebody's life, there are many, many directions you can take the film in, you know. So it was important that we're all on the same page about that. So that should shoot at the end of the year.
So, since you hail from a film family, does it put some undue pressure on you, like regarding your performance or anything? Do you feel that pressure on you?
What do you think?
I think it is there, but you cope up with it and move on and give performances, do your job.
Well, I think that there are many dimensions to this question that you've asked. I think it's quite a layered question. I think it depends on it. It ultimately comes down to, I think, what direction you as an individual, as a person, want to take your career in. Mm-hmm. What sort of films are you drawn to? Because your choices speak volumes about your taste and sensibilities and personality.
Right.
So I haven't really done any typical traditional mainstream Bollywood movies.
Yes.
I haven't really been presented as, here's now Anil Kapoor's son or whatever. Mm-hmm. I've just tried to play characters to my best ability.
Right.
I think obviously people will draw comparisons and all of that. But I actually think the whole drawing comparisons thing is very silly.
Right.
I think that the drawing comparisons is because people are not able to embrace one's individuality. Mm-hmm. So they without kind of trying to really perceive who this person is and what his work is like and what his work stands for,
yes.
They instead, they find it a lot easier to just say, he should be like that or he should.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a bit limiting, but I think what my idea is to, over a period of time, do a bunch of films that kind of create my own identity,
right.
Which is a bit of a longer road. It's a bit of a more a path where you have to be a bit more patient. Mm. But I think it works for me and I think it suits me. And I never came into the industry wanting to be an overnight superstar. And that's not the kind of person that I am.
Yeah.
And I think my choices have reflected that. So there'll always be people that will have an opinion about what I should be doing. But I don't really care, to be honest with you. I'm more interested in doing what I want to do.
Right. So what are the challenges that you think are there for your or Janvi's generation that you have to face, and the challenges that were not faced by Anil sir or Sanjay sir's generation? I know those.
Go ahead.
Yeah, so they had their own struggles, but what are the roadblocks you think that are there for the younger people?
Well, scrutiny, social media.
Yes.
I think the world has completely changed with our obsession with social media.
Yes.
And therefore, that's kind of had an impact on it. I think it used to be a lot bigger, the advantage of kind of being from a film family. I think it's kind of dissipated over the years. And I mean, I can't even compare myself to anybody else, really, because, I'm not claiming to be like, I'm just an actor, and I just happen to be from a film family. But if anybody knows me personally, that they tell you that I'm obsessed with films.
Yes.
I've loved films my entire life, and I'm a cinephile, and I'm, deeply into the process of what I do. And that's not just acting. When I do a film, like the film that I'm doing now, I'm, creatively trying to bring whatever I can,
right.
And collaborating with the people that are making the film, So my whole view is very different, really, on it. As far as challenges, I mean, look, there are always going to be people that are going to say things, but ultimately, I hope people just watch Bhavesh Joshi. They just they watch AK versus AK,
right.
And they like the films, and they understand what I'm trying to kind of do, and that's all I can really do.
So, films like Bhavesh Joshi or Mirzia, these films are discussed on different platforms nowadays, like on Instagram, on different pages. But what do you think have been the reason behind that, that it did not resonate with the masses? What do you think could be the reason behind it?
Because they're not massy films.
Right.
It's quite simple. I think... and I knew that before doing the films, because I've obviously seen my dad be an actor for so many decades.
Yes.
I've seen Sonam be an actress for over 10 years now. So I see the films that work, and I knew that Mirzia and Bhavesh Joshi are not those films, but I still did them. Because for me, my... creative drive and my creative instincts and what I want to do, for me, that's much greater than the greed and ambition of wanting to become a star. So
yes.
I obviously, I mean, we all want the same things, you know. Even I want, I would have been ecstatic if Bhavesh Joshi had done 50 crores.
Right.
It would have made my life a lot easier, you know. Yes. But I will not compromise on my sensibility and my creative integrity to do, you know, something that I don't really believe in just because it has a better chance of making money. Mm-hmm. I would rather try and give the audiences films like Mirza and Bhavesh Joshi, even if there's a higher risk of them not working.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, if you do something that you're passionate about and it ends up resonating with a large number of people,
right,
that's the best feeling in the world, you know. And yes, then that makes your foundation very, very strong. If I do some film that does really well that I don't believe in and I don't plan on doing more films like that in the future, then I'm in a bit of a tough spot, you know,
yes,
because that film is done well and now the audiences are expecting me to do maybe something similar or similar kinds of films, and I don't want to do that.
Yes.
You know, so I was just kind of following my instinct, and then in the last 1 year, the whole world changed with the pandemic, you know, and now everybody's talking about Bhavesh Joshi like they want a sequel, and you know, it's the most underrated film of 2018, and it's this and it's that, and you know, to be honest, I never expected it to really do a lot of numbers, but I did expect. I knew when the film comes on digital, it will reach out to people and it will talk to people.
Yes.
So I'm just very glad that that's happened. And you know, it's all about longevity, right? Like, we don't remember what the first 3 days collections of like The Godfather were. Nobody cares. You know, everybody just talks about the quality of the film. And I feel Bhavesh is something that is even more relevant now than it was when it came out, and will continue to be relevant. And in my mind, Bhavesh Joshi is a successful film, you know, because if you take away the box office that, you know, didn't happen, people are still talking about the film. IMDb, top 200 Hindi films of all time. Google users, 94% people love the film. It has hundreds of thousands of views on YouTube. So if you quantify all of that to box office collections, it would have probably done what it was supposed to do, you know. So that's great.
Also, it when it released, it had a clash with Veeray the Wedding. So that, I think, was the reason why it could not pull off the number you were expecting.
Yeah,
it
you know,
should
maybe,
have.
maybe. But, you know, I think honestly, even if it came out on a regular Friday, I think it might have done better. But see, I always believe that the box office is a indication of how keen an audience is to consume a film.
Right.
It is not always a clear reflection of the quality of the film. They're two very different things, right? Like, if you see a fancy restaurant from a mile away, you're curious to go and eat food at that restaurant.
But maybe the food might not be good.
The food's not so good, you know, but by the time you've already paid the bill, you know? Well, maybe Bhavesh Joshi, the restaurant didn't look as glamorous from the outside.
Yes.
But when actually people went and ate there, they realized that the food is really good. You know, so now people keep going back there to eat the food.
Yes.
So that's the way that I kind of look at it. And I'd rather make good food than be in a fancy restaurant with bad food. You know?
Yes. So before we move on to our lifestyle segment, I would like to ask a last question about movies only. So a career advice that you have received from Anil sir or your sisters that you still follow and has helped you in movies only.
Be true to yourself. Please don't try and be something that you're not.